and I'll wager you've met him as well. His spirit lives on in the ballads he wrote and the stories that he used to tell. He was known right throughout this old nation and as dinkum as you'd ever find. His axe mark is deep in the Gidgee. Yes, this bloke, he was one of a kind. He was carved from an old piece of mulga. You could tell from the cup of each line. He was shaped by the moods of the seasons and honed by the passing of time. His handshake and smile were as warming as the sunlight that breaks through a storm. And his blue eyes revealed an inner sadness like you feel when an old friend has gone. He was stamped with the brand of a bushman, and he kind of stood out in a crowd. His songs are the humour and hardships of life from the bushland of which he was so proud. It was hard to catch up to this wanderer. Like the emu, he was destined to roam. And his paddock was most of Australia, so I suppose he was always at home. There was hardly a job he'd not toil at, and there's seldom a place he'd not been. There's hardly a corner that hides in the scrub with some hardships that he hadn't seen. He was a man who believed in old values, a man who would say what he meant. If at times just a little unforgiving, lay your blame with the hard years he spent. Yes, he wrote for the poor and the needy, and those for whom the world had grown cold. There's hope in his lines for the battler, and tears for the lonely and old. Yes, he walked in the shadow of Lawson, though he never had made such a claim. But ghostly old fingers were guiding the hand for the writings preceding his name. Yes, there's a man who for years I've admired, and I'll wager you've met him as well. And there's a chance you could see him some evening in the bar of Three Rivers Hotel. Yes, he travelled all over Australia. He saw the heart and the soul of this land, and I think you might know who I'm talking about, so we'll just say his first name was Stan.